let's say I'm a person, I'm going to come to you, and I know that you're the best. I know that you do phenomenal work, and I know you're going to be more expensive than everybody else because you're a perfectionist.
Right.
But then I'm going to choose another guy that's a cheapo guy. I'm just going to paint it, and he could be, why, is it a third the price? Because he's leaving out all this kind of stuff and this stuff, none of the stuff we're talking about. I mean, is that realistic?
Yeah. Oh, that's realistic. Oh, definitely.
Yeah. And I'll look at it and I'll think, wow, this looks great. And then in a very short period of time, it's going to be, I'm going to be ticked off.
Well, most people don't realize there are things that look good. I mean, when someone comes in and paints your house,
okay,
unless you look carefully, it looks good.
Okay.
Even if they do a kind of a sloppy job.
Right.
And particularly at first, the first day or two, where the pure paint hasn't cured yet, things are still kind of curing, you know, it looks pretty good. But as if they don't prime properly, for instance, mm-hmm. you in a week or two, if you look carefully, you'll see bare spots or places where the paint was not thick enough, and you'll see a little something showing through. Because
he did it quick, and he didn't get it in there nice and even everywhere.
Correct. The other thing is, maybe if you don't look closely at first, you won't see that they did a careful job of making this line straight somewhere. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
It looks good to you from distance, but you get up close, and then you start realizing, wow, there's some things that really weren't done.
Like right. Holes that they didn't fill in or whatever.
Yeah, like nail holes. Sometimes you need to fill every nail hole. Every single one.
Everyone.
Even the pin, the little tiny pinholes, yeah. Because paint is not made to fill holes. You see,
true.
Putty is made to fill holes. Caulk is made to fill cracks.
Okay.
Primer is made to prepare the surface to paint. And paint is to cover the whole thing, make it look pretty.
Okay.
And if you keep all those things in order, then it looks great. Because paint will not cover nail holes. And some little tiny holes, it will cover for a while, and it might never see it. It might or might not cover. But to count on paint to cover nail hole is not the right logic.
Well, then when you fill in the hole, I would think guys that understand you're supposed to fill in the hole, then they don't even they leave stuff on the wall, right?
Yeah. Well, sometimes you dust that or you sand that, you leave dust on the wall. And secondly, that little spot. Let's say that you filled in.
Okay.
And you sand it down. It's got a spot about this big.
Okay.
Well. The wall around it may have 6 coats of paint or 10 coats of paint. Hard telling how many times it's been painted before.
All right.
And this little spot now has a little spot of putty or drywall mud or something.
That's an inch and around or 2 inches around.
Okay. Now, think about this. If I run my paint over this surface and I've got all this painted around it and it's got 6 coats of paint on it, my paint's going to stand out on that real good. But I hit this little round spot.
Okay.
What's going to happen to the paint?
It's going to be on a different surface.
It's on a different surface. It's going to suck right into that drywall mud, and it's going to call what they call a shiner. If you stand sideways on a wall and look down the wall where you have light reflecting on a wall,
right.
You'll see these little spots where they've been patched, and there's not an even sheen.
And that's not a professional. It doesn't know what they're doing.
Yeah, and you have to spot prime. That's what we call spot priming. And you have to do that right so you don't create edges on your paint, but that takes some skill and some learning how to do that as well. But you spot prime all the places, make sure there's primer over every surface that changes.
You're not really saying that we need to prime everything every time we do this.
No.
But the point is knowing when to do it or when not to do it.
No, when to do it and know when not to do it.
Because then you can keep the cost down at least some, you know.
Right, exactly.
But you do a good job at the end.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Tell me the difference between a cheapo, low ball bid and a bid where a guy is going to be really do a good job. I mean, what are the major differences that are going on there? I mean, let's say yours is $1,000 and this guy quotes, $300 or whatever?
Okay.
And you're both making the same money. Is that possible?